Now, another question concerning the judgment seat of Christ is, do you think that all Christians will receive the same reward from Christ? Or do you think that 10 minutes after you've appeared at the judgment seat of Christ, it's not going to matter for the rest of eternity how well you did at the judgment seat? Well, if you think that, you may be surprised. Listen.
You know, John, it is not true to say that 10 minutes into eternity it won't matter how well I did at the judgment. Because as we shall be pointing out, the way in which we live here has repercussions throughout all of eternity. I'm even suggesting that possibly some people will not get the opportunity to reign with Jesus Christ because of unfaithfulness. Because reigning with Christ is always conditional. If we suffer with Him, we shall reign with Him, the Scripture says. If we are overcomers, we shall be able to reign with Him. But perhaps we can discuss that in more detail in a future program. But how thorough is this judgment going to be? All right, visualize two Christians who can't get along. Maybe they've been divorced. All kinds of awful things are said between them. But both of them are believers. Both of them are going to appear in heaven. Do you mean to tell me that when they get to heaven, they're going to walk in hand and old animosities, all forgotten, all hushed up, everything pretending to be okay? No, it's the judgment seat of Jesus Christ where final reconciliation and adjudication will take place. That's why the Apostle Paul could say this to the people at Corinth. Therefore, do not go on passing judgment before the time, but wait until the Lord comes, who will both bring to light the things hidden in darkness and disclose the motives of men's hearts, and then each man's praise will come to him from God. It is at the judgment seat of Jesus Christ that final justice will be brought. People perhaps have said things about you that are false. They've wronged you deeply, and you've not been able to reconcile it. It's at the judgment seat where it's all going to come out, and God is going to show Himself to be perfectly just. That's why the Apostle Paul can say, "Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves. I will recompense, says the Lord. I will repay." We usually think of that in relationship to the unconverted, but Paul is talking about believers also. And throughout all of eternity, we are going to sing, "Just and true are thy ways, thou King of saints." That's why the respected theologian, John Murray, even says that we as believers will want this kind of judgment as we stand before Jesus Christ. We will want to see His graciousness. We will want to see the final judgment on sin and the reconciliation that should have taken place here on earth, but is going to have to wait until heaven before it happens.